And very simply, for anybody who struggles with their body composition, I wish you the best. I sincerely wish you the best in your health and fitness journey. I want people to live long and healthy lives. And the health information that people like Tess Holliday put out there for millions of people to see is simply factually incorrect. It is science denial and it is harmful. There is no biological free lunch when it comes to excess amounts of body fat. You are creating an unhealthy environment within your body if you are storing too much body fat. And by unhealthy, I can break that down to unhealthy cells, which subsequently lead to organ tissues. Ultimately, it's not just the decreased ability to perform daily activities using mobility and cardiovascular endurance, but it's also the very serious factor that large amounts of body fat accumulation lead to serious disease and, in the worst cases, with morbid endings. And so very simply, the idea that extreme amounts of body fat are healthy is science denial. And to put that in words that Madeline Giorgetta would understand. And if you don't know who she has the Insta virus. She's an Instagram model with millions of subscribers who shows her rear end in almost all her pictures and now is suddenly censoring the word obesity and also spouting absolute nonsense when she talks about the topic. And so I understand that this is a very emotional topic for many people. And for me, it's a topic that I've actually not ever made a video upon before. I've made a video about visceral fat and the dangers of it, but I've not made a video specifically on Tess Holliday. I referenced her in my last video. It's something which greatly pains me. I find it incredibly frustrating, and I really struggle to watch some of the content I see. When it comes to the idea that having excessive amounts of body fat is somehow healthy, is simply incorrect. And this is a very dangerous message, because if people are to take this at face value, this could have morbid consequences. However, I also dislike the abuse that's aimed at these people promoting excessive amounts of body fat as healthy. And by abuse, I mean vile abuse. Not debating them, not critiquing them, that's absolutely fine. But some of the abusive and vile comments that you will see on social media, that does not help this issue at all. And what I will say is that when it comes to Tess Holliday, she's putting information out there publicly. She's absolutely profiting from creating content on this topic. Of course people can debate and critique her. Of course, people like Every Damn Day Fitness, whose work, whose profession is coaching people down to healthy ranges of body fat, of course he has the right to critique her information. They're at the polar ends of the spectrum when it comes to this issue. So this idea that why is everyone talking about Tess Holliday? Because she's publicly voicing a polar opinion at the other end of the spectrum. And it's simply wrong information. And it can be highly misleading to many people with very serious consequences. There is absolutely no doubt when we look at the scientific literature that obesity brings about risk of disease. And in this video, I'm going to discuss that in relation to low-grade inflammation in relation to your gut and adipose tissue. And in addition, I'm going to discuss the idea that we cannot just say to people who are obese looking to lose body fat, just go and exercise. That is not specific enough. We have to give specific exercise protocols and regimens to people who are obese looking to lose body fat. And I'm very careful also to discuss this purely from a biological, scientific, and health standpoint. That's all I'm interested in. And also, I will always say excessive amounts of body fat or large amounts of body fat. I will never just say body fat or fat, because fat in our body has important functions. And so having body fat is actually needed. And that's why being extremely underweight can be a severe health risk as well. Fat has many functions, for example, energy storage. You can think of your body fat as stored energy. But it also has other functions in relation to insulation, in relation to hormonal applications, and also protecting your organs from trauma. When you see people 4% body fat on the bodybuilding stage, absolutely, these are dangerous levels of body fat. This is not a healthy physique. And then conversely, obese and morbidly obese people, again, this is not a healthy range of body fat. And so on opposite ends of the scale, we can understand how an extremity of body fat either way is not a healthy body composition. And an accumulation of body fat is very simple to explain. It is caused by a caloric surplus, a positive energy balance where you're intaking more calories than you are expending over a consistent and chronic period of time. Now, the response of the body to this will be the increase in body fat, triacylglyceride, adipocytes, adipose tissue. However, the metabolic adaptation to that will be a speeding up of your metabolism. The larger you become, the more body fat you accumulate, your metabolism actually gets faster. You've heard this myth of, well, people who have large amounts of body fat have this because they have a slow metabolism. That's complete nonsense. It's actually the opposite way around, because your body's looking for homeostasis. So the larger your mass becomes, the more your metabolism has to ramp up to try and create a level of homeostasis. And I have a video on that too. However, we have to note that there are certain populations of people who have certain medical issues which do contribute to obesity, such as PCOS, thyroid issues, hormonal issues. However, that is the minority. That is not the statistical majority. I'm going to project some insight from Dr. Eddie Joan. He has great infographics that people may look into. And essentially, he discusses, and we know in the scientific literature, that low-grade inflammation is a serious problem with obesity. And so this low-grade inflammation comes from two factors, if you like. It comes from adipose tissue and also the gut. First, obesity provokes changes in accumulated adipose tissue that result in altered fat cell metabolism and dysfunction, as well as increased infiltration of inflammatory cells. Altogether, this promotes inflammation of adipose tissue, fat tissue, resulting in increased release of a variety of small proteins called adipokines, much of which are pro-inflammatory mediators. Secondly, gut tissue also undergoes changes with obesity, such as gut inflammation. Altered gut microbiota and increased intestinal wall permeability, causing continuous endotoxin leakage into circulation. Thus, obesity is linked to chronic low-grade endotoxemia. And so this obesity creates this environment within your body due to your fat tissue and your gut. And this is very severe, as your heart and your liver and other vital organs are affected by this inflammation, the chronic production of inflammatory factors, which can lead to an inflammatory environment. In this case, obesity absolutely brings about risk in terms of inflammation, your organs, which is linked to many major diseases. And so when it comes to very low amounts of body fat, we have this process called adaptive thermogenesis. I have a video on that. Essentially, what that is when you're in a caloric deficit for a chronic period of time, and when you get very lean and your body fat percentages are dropping and dropping and getting low, your body actually kicks in certain mechanisms. It adapts. Adaptive thermogenesis, where essentially it encourages you to eat to try and put on some more body fat and more mass. And so that's specific to being underweight. And when we have obesity, now obesity I would talk about in terms of body fat percentage. You can also measure this in terms of waist to hip circumference, but just saying someone is a certain amount of weight may not give the full story, because people have certain heights, certain frames. If you're a 5'2" female and 250 pounds, that's very different to being a 6'5" male and 250 pounds, for example. But I need to be very clear with people, when we look at the scientific literature, when we become evidence-based, there is no debate as to whether being obese is healthy or not. It simply is not. It brings about too much of a risk of disease, and it creates an unhealthy environment in relation to yourselves, as I will explain. The debate really comes as to how do we treat this? How do we try and prevent and treat obesity? That's really where the research and the literature is now. But it's not just good enough to say to people who are looking to lose body fat, obese people looking to lose body fat, just go and exercise. That is not okay. We have to be more specific with our prescriptions. And interestingly, there's a new piece of research by Sun et al. 2018, which took obese women and put them through different training protocols. And as Dr. Eddie Joe concludes when he looked into this research, he says, the common prescription of 30 minutes of walking at least 3 times a week, or the even more vague get more exercise advice, is unacceptable. There is sufficient data to suggest that changes in cardio-metabolic health variables vary depending on the exercise program employed. The overall higher intensity training programs yielded superior cardiometabolic outcomes, for example, a significant reduction in insulin resistance. And so most certainly, these are the areas to look into: programming of exercise for obese people, not whether it's unhealthy to be obese. We've got to break through some of this misinformation, and we really have to focus and develop on the really important research that's being looked at now, which will ultimately save people's lives. When it comes to this specific issue that she talks about with the health of having large amounts of body fat, it's simply something that cannot go uncontested. Very simply, scientific evidence-based information has to rise up to the forefront, because it could be absolutely vital for people who may get confused in this labyrinth of disinformation that is currently being put out there. And so I'm James Linker. This is Shredded Sports Science. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. You may not feel too many health ramifications for your morbid obesity now. In the next 5 to 10 years, you will. And that's terrible. My own father died from health conditions related to obesity when I was 15, which caused me to go into medicine and study this illness. Now, before anyone jumps on me, I'm not saying that you are not beautiful. Tess, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. But I am saying that you are terribly unhealthy. And I, and I'm sure many others, encourage you to eat a healthy, nutritious diet and get plenty of exercise, which I've seen you are starting to do, so keep up the good work. I hate to say it, but if you don't make a change, you may not live long enough to see your son, Bowie, graduate high school. This isn't hate. I just want to warn you about the health risks if you continue down this unhealthy path.